straight, everything's solid. Thanks, guys. Up well. Tip after striking, is it still drilling? Here's the hole that landed. Everything is straight, nothing loose. Down here, let's see how we did. Here's the edge, here's the strike points. Looks like it's holding up fine. Looks like the edge is holding up well. Sound of good tempering. Moving on to the next test. Compare edges here. Here's my edge. Here's the edge damage to the cheek. Hopefully you guys can see just the difference. Holding up very well. Good tempering. Still straight. Took some edge damage, of course, but not too bad. Nothing that can't be ground out. Overall, not bad. Everything is solid. Nothing has come loose. Everything's tight. Held up very well. I will give my final thoughts. Hello, Jason Woodard here with my final thoughts on my newest design. This is the Dark Ninjato 2. I have redesigned it from the first one. It is now a little bit shorter, a little bit wider, has a different grip and pommel. Things I really like about this is, first of all, it bounces great. It's just a few inches past the guard. It's got a good finger groove, and you can really feel this when you're doing swings. I like the pommel design. It's got a little bit of a rise, so your hand doesn't slip down. And of course, the black deerskin leather wrap is a huge benefit. It holds better, it doesn't slip, absorbs even more shock. It held up very well to all of my harsh testing. It cut very well. It feels really good in the hands. It's heavy, but it's not too heavy, with a good balance point. This is not a weak person's sword, don't get me wrong. It is meant to withstand a lot. It's meant to withstand a lot of abuse, and it did. With the Doomsday line, our whole theme is overbuilt, heavy duty, something that's not going to break in an emergency if you actually have to use it. So these swords aren't for everybody, and I encourage you not to test these swords the way I do. I wear as much protective gear as I can put on to be safe, and my whole goal is to make sure these hold up well so that they won't cause any injury to anybody else if they buy one. Held up well, still stayed straight. I cut wood, jugs, metal. I stabbed it through a steel drum. I stabbed it through a vehicle's hood. I struck it against a cheap katana, and it held up well. The edge took the most damage striking the granite, of course. Any sword's going to take a little damage. But I ground that right off. It was no issue, and it held up very well. You can also get this nice buffalo hide sheath to go with it that fits well in that. These are made to order by Chris Palmer. And this is a Sword Buyer's Guide exclusive, in partnership with Paul Southern at the Sword Buyer's Guide. So thank you guys for watching. This one's already selling well, and I appreciate everybody's support. The Doomsday line is doing great.